these three only you need to know about the physical body.
Swamiji, maybe I'm fighting with words, but then without I means there is no consciousness in that stage at all.
You just imagine that night time there is no sun at all. Can you say in the night time there is no sun? Sun is there, we can't see.
Yeah.
Same way, the consciousness is there, we can't see.
That's the without I.
That is what I call, I say without I for the sake of your understanding. We can't say, there is no space where there is no I. There is, in a way, you can say, there is no time where there is no sun. There is no time when there is no sun. But we say, the night time there is no sun. Just like that, for the sake of your understanding, I like to use that word, without I.
Swami, we can say unconditioned I. We can say in that state.
No, again, the conditioned, unconditioned I means, you start thinking that you need to, as if unconditioned the I. There is no need to uncondition the I, you need to uncondition the thoughts, that's all. I wanted to use the such a safe words, so that you can understand the process is also a simple process. If you use the wrong words, then you will start thinking about the process. Oh, it's a big. The process is not too big. Finished?
So the blank space on the chart is talking about
samadhi.
That's the blank space.
Super consciousness. Let me explain about the physical body. About the food, ahara, few things. I'm just going to give a few tips, step by step. I'm not going to give you rules. Don't have any rules in your life. If you have, the moment you start having rules, immediately you start hating the rules. Any rule, you will start hating. Never have any rule. Have only understandings. I have seen many guys suffering more because of the guilt they have eaten wrong food. The wrong food itself, the food itself wouldn't have created any problem. But the guilt would have created a lot more problems. Once in a while, somewhere you go to some party and drink or smoke and come away. The drinking and smoking itself wouldn't have caused so much of problem. But this guilt would have created more trouble. Of course, I'm not encouraging go around and drink or do whatever you want. I'm not encouraging that. But I'm telling you, don't create too much of guilt in your being. Don't create much rules, even in your day-to-day life. Yesterday I was not explaining on that because I was speaking in the temple, so I do not want to. Now I can explain. I have seen many people who create the regular routine of doing puja. In the first beginning, when you started doing puja, you must have felt some ecstasy, joy, some enthusiasm. When you start every day as a regular routine, in a month or two, it will become a dead routine. Afterwards, for next month, if you have fear, out of fear you will be continuing. And after that, you will be just waiting, when I will finish the puja and come out. When I will finish the puja and escape from the room. Because the moment you make something as rule, you can see, you spoil the whole thing. Whole joy is spoiled. Whole love is spoiled. The moment you make something as a rule, the whole thing is lost. The whole idea is lost. So don't make as a rules. Make these few things as a understanding. When you make anything as rule, you make it dull. So make these few things as understanding about your life. Let me give the few understandings about food. Don't take any food which can make your logic imbalance, which can make you lose your consciousness, means alcohol, drugs, and the food which makes you continuously feel sleepy, lethargic. That's all. No other rule. That's all. Only these two rule, which makes your consciousness dull. Don't allow those things inside your system. For example, what for you are eating? Tell me. What for you are eating?
To live.
For energy. After eating the food, if you feel dull and lethargic, feeling like going and sleeping, what it means?
Overeating
or wrong food? Overeating, huh?
Sugar.
Overeating or?
Sweets.
Wrong food. So, don't allow the food inside your system, which immediately makes you feel like sleeping. Basic thing. There is no need for anything else. The second thing, when you eat, don't entertain restlessness in your being, and don't eat the food cooked by the people who are restless by themselves. Here comes little difficulty. First thing in understanding and in practicing. First, let us understand why. There is a beautiful saying from an enlightened master. When you cook, don't think you put only your ingredients. You put your thoughts also and cook. Your thoughts are also added when you cook. When you cook, your thoughts are also added. That's the important thing you need to notice. And there's one more thing, beautiful thing. A Zen story. A king goes to a master and asks the master, "Master, I know that you are always living in joy and ecstasy and bliss. You are so alive, bubbling. What is the reason? What is the technique you practice? Please guide us. Please teach us." Master said, "Technique? I eat when I eat, I sleep when I sleep, that's all." The king cannot understand. "What are you talking? What do you mean by it?" Master says, "I eat when I eat, I sleep when I sleep. Do you do that?" King says, "Yes, everyone does. When we eat, we eat. When we sleep." Master says, "No. Look, when you eat, the time of your eating only, you will start doing all sorts of brooding over about the past, planning for the future. You will be either worrying about the future or worrying about the past. You never eat relating to the food. Relating to the food is one of the important thing, because the food is going to become part of your being. You are going to eat. It is going to become just part of your being. It is going to become your own self. But you never bother, you never care to relate with the food. First thing, eating with the hand itself is a technique to relate with the food. Eating with the hand is a wonderful way to relate with the food. Eating with, not only that, there are 10 energy centers in your both hands. The fingers, tip of the fingers, 10 energy centers. Those 10 energy centers make your body adjusted or prepares your body to the food when you touch the food. When you touch the food, actually, even if the person who is having wrong thoughts, even if he cooks, even if there are wrong thoughts in the food, it will be cleansed. Food will be prepared. The energy of the food will be adjusted for your own body energy. So instead of touching the food directly by mouth, touch it by hand. According to me, wash both hands and put both hands and eat through both hands. You may ask, what are you teaching, Swamiji? But you do not know. You do not know the value of it. Only when you know the consciousness or a spiritual background, you will understand. In Zen, if you are taking a cup of tea, you are supposed to hold the cup of tea with whole hand, both hands. And all the 10 fingertips has to touch the cup. Then only you are allowed to drink. Then only you are allowed to drink. And not only that, you do not know consciously how much makes the difference. Try today, just try today. Wash your hands thoroughly. Put both your hands and feel the food and take the food little by little and put the food in the mouth and nicely enjoy, relish, deeply enjoy and swallow. Don't just grab the food. If you grab the food, you do not even know the quantity. And it will go inside so much, you will not even know the quantity. See, when I say, this all looks very simple, but eating is the habit, your basic habit. Everyday activity. One more thing, people come and tell me, Swamiji, I don't have time to do meditation, I don't have time to do dhyana, I don't have time to do puja. I tell them, don't bother at all. Just convert your eating into meditation, that's enough. If you practice these few basic things, the very eating itself will become meditation. The very eating will become meditation. You can't say, I don't have time to eat. Do you say? You eat properly. So, instead of saying, I don't have time to meditate, convert the eating into meditation. Let the eating itself become a meditation. Start eating in a very meditative way. Put both hands and, if possible, sit with closed eyes for 1 or 2 minutes and don't bother about any other work. First, don't watch TV or don't do anything else when you eat. Put both hands. Feel almost you are praying. Be in the mood of prayer. Be in the same mood of meditation and start putting the food inside your body, you will see your whole being is totally different. And not only that, your body will automatically inform you when to stop. At particular time, you will stop. You will never overeat. No animal suffers the obesity. We are the only animal who suffer obesity problem. Have you seen any animal suffering obesity problem? In India, cows will be tied just near the straw. Straw will be 24 hours it will be available to them. But they will never overeat. They never suffer overeating. If 1 or 2 animals overeat, means maybe a habit from you. They picked up from us. You are keeping the pet food always for the dogs. Have you seen any dog overeating? Yes, you have seen. It means you are training them. You have trained them. And you see, now I am surprised, the pet animals here, they catch cold. In India, I have never seen any animal catching cold. I have never seen. Here, because too much when you take care, it becomes almost like you. All the attitudes of human beings are picked up by the pet animals. No wild animals catches cold. No wild animals suffer so much of disease like pet animals. These poor guys, because you are giving food, they take your mental setup also. They pick up your mental setup. They pick up your attitude, your lifestyle, your everything, and it suffers. I have not seen any wild animal suffering the loneliness. But all pet animals suffer loneliness. Leave them alone and go. So, they pick up your attitude. That is the reason they may be overeating. Not by nature. Anyhow, understand these few things about eating. Just avoid the food which creates lethargic feeling. on the imbalance of consciousness. Next, try to eat with the present moment.